Welcome back, amigos, to another After Effects tutorial. And for this one, we'll be creating the light warp speed effect that I used for the Aaron Donald piece that I made for the NFL. Now, there are two ways to create this effect. One, using the plugins that comes with After Effects, and number two, using Trapcode Particular. In this tutorial, you'll get a bonus because I'll show you both methods. And remember, amigos, that life is truly a gift. Make it count. Let's start by creating a new composition. I'll make it 1920 by 1080, 29.97 frames per second, 5 seconds long, and the background color will be black. Hit okay, hit okay. To create this effect, we'll apply it to a solid layer. Hit Control Y, Command Y. To create a solid layer, we'll make it comp size, and the initial color of the particle will come from the solid layer. However, later on, if you want to change the color, you can add a fill or a gradient ramp. For now, let's make it green, hit okay, and let's apply two effects. The first one, let's go to effect, we'll go down to simulation, and let's go to CC starburst, and let's play it back. And we are in space. It looks like we're in space. Now let's modify some of these parameters. The first one is a scatter. Let's make it 700. And let's increase the speed to 5. Let's check it out. Okay, now let's add the echo effect. Go to effect, go to time, and we'll go to echo. And for the echo time, let's modify this value to 0.001. And the number of echoes, let's make it 60. And let's do a ramp preview. Let's check it out. Now the echo effect is a little heavy, so just give it some time to do the ramp preview. And there you go. If you want to change the color, you can go to the solid layer, go to layer, solid settings, and from here you can change the color, or you can add a fill, go down to generate, go down to fill. You can also add a gradient ramp. Go to generate gradient ramp. And for example, we can select radial. And these are different options that you have. Now, my go-to plugin to create particles or this effect is Trapcode Particular because it gives you a lot more flexibility. It gives you a lot more options. So the rest of this tutorial, I'll show you how you can recreate this using Trapcode Particular. Let's create a new composition. We'll make it 1920 by 1080, 29.97. Feel free to change the frame rate. And let's make it 5 seconds long and hit okay. Now to add particular, we need to add it to a solid layer. So hit Control Y, Command Y to create a solid layer. Make it comp size and the color doesn't matter. You can make it any color. And let's go ahead and add particular. Go to effect, RG trap code, and go down to particular. I have to be honest, amigos, particular is not the easiest plugin to understand or master. It definitely took some time for me to really understand. So I'm gonna do my best to break it down as easily as possible. And hopefully by the end of this video, you'll have a better understanding of how particular works. Now, the cool thing is once you start playing, automatically it's emitting particles. All we need to do is modify the right properties to get the look that we want. So let's go back, and to start out with, let's go to emitter. And for the emitter behavior, we have a couple options. If we choose explode, it'll be an explosion of particles, like a one-time deal. And we also have continuous, which will continue to emit particles in infinity. If you want to increase the amount or the number of particles, just go to particles per second. You can make this, for example, 650. You can see that there's a lot more particles being emitted. If you want fewer, just make it closer to a value of 0. For example, if we have 20, not a lot of particles. So let's go back and let's leave it at the default value of 100. We can change the type of emitter. And we have different options, and this would be for another tutorial to explain the difference.
For this one, we'll be using a point emitter, and we can move our emitter. We can change the location, the position. We can also go here and we can modify the position by modifying these values. Remember that this is the X, the Y, and the Z. Let's go back and make it 960 by 540 by zero. We can also change the direction. And again, this is for another tutorial. For now, we'll go and select uniform. Now, if you want to change the speed of your particles being emitted, go to the velocity and increase this value. Let's make it closer to 800. And you can see that the particles are being emitted a lot faster. If you want to decrease, just make it closer to zero. Let's make it 50. Let's check it out. And you can see that it's going a lot slower. For this effect, let's make it 1000. When you run particular, at the beginning, there are no particles. And if you want to start with particles already being there, already existing, or already in motion, what you need to do is go to the emissions extras, drill down to the pre-run, and we can increase this value, for example, 75%. And from the very beginning, there are already particles that are already there and in motion. So that's what we'll do for this one. Now, once you're done with the emitter, let's go to the next tab, which is the particle tab. And we have different options to modify the look of our particles. The first one is the lifespan, and this is the lifespan of the particle in seconds. We'll leave it at the default value of 3. You also have different types of particles that you can select. And again, this would be for another tutorial to show you the difference. For this effect, I went ahead and I selected sphere. Now, we can increase the size of our particle. And for this sphere, you can see that we have a heavy feather. So what we'll do is go to the sphere feather, and let's make it 0. And let's go back down to the size. And let's make the size a value of 4. We have options to randomize the size, the opacity. We'll leave it at 0, which means we don't want any size randomization or opacity randomization as well. We'll leave the opacity at 100. And what we'll do is go down to the color. We can change the color. Let's see if we can see it with blue. And we have a couple options for set color. We have at the start, which will be at the very beginning, and it'll select this color. We can also choose over life and random from gradient. If you select these two options, for this one, we'll select over life. Then we can go to this option, color over life, and it'll use the colors from this color ramp. We have different options, different presets that we can select from. And we can also use our very own colors. We can double click, for example, this one will make it yellow, and this one will make it blue. So we have these, we have the LA Rams color. Now, to get the look that I used for the Aaron Donald piece, I went down to the auxiliary system, the aux system. Remember the movie Inception? It's a dream within a dream. Think of this as a particle within a particle. Basically, every particle will be its very own emitter and emit particles, which is pretty cool because you can do cool things with this feature, this option. And to enable the auxiliary system, just go to emit and select continuously. If we play it back, it doesn't look really good. What we need to do is increase the particles per second. Let's make it 100. Let's check it out. And it's getting closer to that look. Let's zoom in and we can see the little dots, the little sphere. What we need to do is we need to increase the particles per second. Let's make it 250 so we can see more of a straight line. This is looking better. Now, if you want to decrease the length of the line, simply decrease the lifespan. Right now it's at 0.5, which is half a second. Let's make it 0.3, and we've shortened the length of the line. Now we have very similar properties. You can see feather, Let's make it zero. We have size, size random, opacity, opacity random. These are the same properties that we have for our main particle as well. What we'll do is the opacity, let's make it 100. The random, we'll leave it at zero. We can also change the color, right here. However, we want to use a color from our main particle, from this gradient that we have. Remember the gradient that we selected. And to do that, what we'll do is we'll go to this property called color from main, and we'll make it 100%. So it'll be using 100% of the color from our main particle, which is this color ramp. And what we can do is let's match the same size as our main particle. The size is 4, so let's go down to the auxiliary system and let's also make it 4. So we have the exact same size. If you want to increase the number of particles being emitted, go to our emitter tab and we can increase this to 150, for example. And we can go ahead and add a glow. Go to stylize, go down to glow, and let's modify these properties. And that's pretty much it, amigos. This is the basics of creating this effect that I use for the Aaron Donald piece for the NFL. Hopefully you have a better understanding of how Trapcode Particular works. If you create something, please share it. Would love to see what you come up with. And remember that life is truly a gift. Make it count.